So if you own a MacBook, you may be wondering how your battery is doing, how old it is really, because you figure if you leave your MacBook plugged in most of the time, then it's got to be in better condition than, say, somebody that's using their battery every day. And you'd be right. Or maybe you've already heard of something called battery cycle count and you're wondering how to find out what your cycle count is for your MacBook and what it means. So here I am on my MacBook Pro, and if I go to the Apple menu, you can see I've got About This Mac. But if I hold down the Option key, About This Mac changes to System Information. And that brings up System Information about my Mac with a whole bunch of different categories here on the left. If I go to Power, then I get information both about AC power here at the bottom and also about my battery. And there you'll find the cycle count. In this case, the cycle count for my MacBook Pro is 48. So what does a cycle count mean? Well, it's a total number of times you've used your entire battery. So, for instance, if you start at 100%, you use your battery all the way down to 0, then that's 1. But if you use your battery only down to 50 and then you charge it up again, that's only half. So you have to do that twice to be 1 cycle count. Now with modern MacBooks, you don't have to worry about how far down you discharge your battery while you're using it and how often you charge it up. It doesn't matter. Just use it plugged in when you can and not plugged in when you don't have power nearby. And don't worry about discharging your battery the entire time. It's perfectly okay to use your MacBook without ever getting close to 0 and charging it up. It's not going to increase your cycle count. Matter of fact, it'll lessen your cycle count if you keep it plugged in all the time when it's using regular AC power rather than battery. So don't ever feel that you need to completely use your battery up at any time to calibrate it or do something else. A lot of information on the internet is talking about old style laptop batteries, not the modern MacBook batteries that have been around for years now. So your cycle count gives you a general idea of health. If you're using your MacBook a lot, like say you use it every day on battery, then it's typical to see a number around 300 for a year, because 365 days in a year, maybe minus some weekend days, you're going to use the battery up about once a day. But if you're someone like me who keeps it at their desk most of the time and maybe on weekends or on trips uses the battery, you're going to be at 48 even after only 6 months use. If after several years you see that number getting closer to 1,000, then you got to be thinking about maybe that the battery is maybe at the end of its life. But don't worry about it too much as long as you see the condition of the battery is equal to normal. Now if you want to know more about cycle count, you can go to this page at apple.com right here, and you can read more about battery cycles. They have lots of information here, and they even give some suggested cycle count limits. For instance, for the latest MacBooks, you can see that they consider 1,000 to be the maximum cycle count. For older ones, much older ones, you can see it was only at about 300. For the MacBook Pros, you can see for a long time here, it has been at about 1,000. So you can get a good general idea of when your MacBook's battery life may be near its end and needs replacement.